Hello, hi, welcome to the Lipstick Chat. We are back with a quick update of my brother's keeper. Forgive my voice, I've got flu. Toba is discussing with Usubusiso Gutsi how much could they have or are they going to get should Ashone Umsheng, should Umsheng die in hospital, or how much will they get? And then Usubusiso asks Gutsi, Vele, do you really want money from a person that you do not like? I was like, I loved money is money, man. Money is money. Who it comes from, it does not matter. As long as it's good money, it must come. Puseletso is being rejected by her husband. Her husband does not want anything to do with Puseletso. Every time he sees Upuseletso, he sees the betrayal. Upuseletso does not know how to handle this whole situation because to her, it's a situation that must pass. However, her husband is like, no, I cannot forgive. I cannot see you. I cannot touch you. To an extent, he does not even want Upuseletso to iron his clothes. While dining on the table, having some fun, as Mshengu family, Uyangena, Mshengu, we're happy to be back healthy as I don't know what. He was able to dance. The only thing that was short was for him to climb the roof and jump down with excitement because he was really excited to come back, and the family was not. Umamkhulu asked him to move out, but Mshengu said, "This is my house. I'm not going to move out." Ufakazile, on the other hand, went to check Ukuthi what is Nqubeko's status statement rather saying. Ugo got her the shock of her life when she got to the police station, realizing that Unqubeko had changed the statement, and the statement now does not agree with the allegations that are labeled against Umshengu, meaning Umshengu will walk. And even if he writes another statement saying what I told the first time was true, now the court has a loophole to fight against when it comes to court. Will their marriage survive this thing? Because Ufakazile at this point feels very, very betrayed.